late today. It's currently 9:20, and I was debating on even going to the gym, but we're going, so let's get ready. Recently, I've been switching between these two toothpaste. This one is for sensitivity, and then this one is just for like whitening. We're gonna use this one today.
Like, where are you, Yeezy? And try to hit you with the old wapty till I get flashed by the paparazzi.
If you didn't already make your bed this morning, do me a favor. Go make your bed. Just make it a habit. Every day, every morning, make your bed. Get a good start to your day.
I never thought that you would take it this far. What do I know?
Good morning, YouTube! Right now, we are obviously on the way to the gym, but before we go to the gym, I need to make a quick pit stop at the doctor's office to do a quick test, and then we'll be off to the gym. Doctor's office is complete. That took about 30 minutes. Right now, it's 10:30. We are running late! And the worst part about it is that I forgot the extra batteries for this camera, and I need them because one battery will literally die, like, a fourth of the way through my workout. Like, I need to keep switching the batteries while I'm at the gym. We got the extra batteries and we're on our way to the gym right now. Oh, God. I really hope this thing doesn't fall. Today is chest and shoulder day, but I'm also gonna try to make it more of like a HIIT workout like I was talking about in my last video, just so I could get a little bit more cardio going. I feel like when I first started working out, I would always neglect certain body parts just because I wanted others to look bigger first. Like, literally, when I first started working out, I would only work out my arms and my chest. I wouldn't even work out my back, and I would not work out my legs. So, like, I thought that was okay. Like, it actually ended me up disproportional. Like, if you guys ever see my legs, like, I have zero calves. And as I've been working out for, like, these past couple years consistently, I've began to, like, really focus in on those body parts. Like, my calves, my back, my shoulders, my forearms. I didn't even know there were workouts for your forearms, but there are. When you neglect certain body parts, you kind of like short yourself because those body parts are not going to be strong for working out your other body parts. And let me give you an example. If you're not working out your shoulders, then when you're doing your chest, like your bench press, your shoulders are not going to be able to help and you're not going to be able to lift as heavy. So you need to work out like the accessory. I like that word. You need to work out your accessory body parts, like your shoulders, your rear shoulders, your calves, so that way that all of your other body parts are working fully. While we're on our way to the gym, I want to talk about the importance of setting a goal for yourself and sticking to that goal and being consistent in completing that goal. Because I used to be the type of person where I would set a goal and then I just wouldn't even like pursue it. Like, the thought of it was so nice, but I would barely put in any effort if I even put in effort. And so over this past year, maybe year and a half, I've really been setting my intention towards a goal that I wanted and just going after it and chasing the hell out of it. Like, that's what you need to do. Like, forever, whatever goals you have, set the goal and don't just set it. Chase it and work towards it, because whatever your goal is, it's not gonna happen unless you're putting in consistent work. Set goals for yourself. Like, it doesn't have to be so frequent. Just set a goal, work towards it. If it's something small, making your bed every morning, set it as your goal and do it. If it's some big dream of yours that you've been like dreaming about, set yourself a goal and work towards it. Do everything you can to get to it. So that being said, one of my recent goals was just to be more consistent on all of my platforms and to just really put in maximal effort into all of my content. Not to say I wasn't before, but I just felt like there was room for more improvement. Like, there's always room for improvement. So I'll give you an example of some goals that I set. I wanted to post every other day on Instagram. Ever since I've had TikTok, I've always posted every day except for one day of the week I'll give myself off. So that's staying the same. For YouTube, I want to post one YouTube video at the end of every week, except for maybe 1 week out of the month I'll give myself off. I had set these goals, right? And when I first set them and I was being consistent with them, I was really Like, I just wanted to give up. I was like, okay, I need to drop something, just get it off of my plate so I can have a little bit more room here, a little bit more free time. I forced myself to stick to the goals that I set, and I just wrote it out a little bit. And after like a week and a half, I just feel much better. Like, I can now manage everything on my plate and even add more on top of that. So I feel like that's really like all about growing. Like, you need to force yourself to grow to be able to take on more, but not in an unhealthy way. Like, if you feel like it's damaging your mental health, then by all means, please take a break. But if you don't, and you really feel like you have the ability to push through it, but you might just let that little bit of laziness get you, that's where you gotta stop yourself. Because I sometimes let that laziness get to me, and it's not okay. I kick that shit right to the curb. By laziness, we got goals. We got things we wanna do. Like, my future is riding on me, and I'm not gonna give up to that little bit of laziness. So kick the laziness to the curb and get your ass to work. I'll see you guys at the gym. Chest and shoulders and a little bit of HIIT.
She be busy popping tags. She got a lot of Prada, that Dolce and Gabbana. I can't forget Escada and that Balenciaga. I'm sipping purple syrup, come be my Aunt mama. And if you is a rider, we go shopping like manana. Her attitude Rihanna, she get it from her mama. She jiggy like Madonna, but she trippy like Nirvana. Cause everything designer. Her jeans is Helmut Lang, shoes is Alexander Wang. And her shirt the new is Donna Karen, wearing all the Cartier frame, Jean Paul Gaultier's, cause they match with her persona.
Her pistol go, her pistol go, her pistol go, her pistol go. I said her pistol go,
cause she a fashion killer, and I'm a trendy nigga. I said
her pistol go, her pistol go, I said her pistol go, cause she a fashion.
Workout is complete. You guys, the weather is so nice today. It's 75 degrees right now, sunny, it's hot. I don't even know what to do. Like, what should I do today? I mean, I have work to do, but I'm trying to go swimming. Right now I'm gonna pick up lunch from this sushi bowl place. It's just like rice, sushi, and then they put some like vegetables. Can I have a large iced green tea lemonade sweetened? This is the drink of the summertime. A large iced green tea lemonade sweetened with classic sweetener, not liquid cane, classic. I put one extra pump for fun, but you don't have to. My battery's about to die, but let me do a taste test. See you guys later.
Hi guys, we're on our way to take pictures with Ava, per usual, what's new. I wanted to do a quick fit check and give you guys the vibe right before we leave. This is the fit. These cream parachute pants, and then this cream shirt. They're kind of like not matching, but I kind of like that though. And then I just have this bag and this hat to match. I don't want to put the hat on right now. Farmer's market vibe, so we're gonna go to like a farmer's market and see what we can do.
The weather, it's like 71 degrees. There's not a cloud in the sky. The vibes are high. The vibes are high. Apparently the car doesn't think so.
Whoa, baby, poke it out, poke it out, poke it out, poke it out. You got me begging, begging, mama, will you still be here?
Not on the chair. Why would you put shoes on my chair? Like, that's... disrespectful.
Guys, glasses or no glasses?
Are those purple?
No, they're red.
So basically, we came to the market and everything is closed. This ain't looking too good. I mean, it is Tuesday and it's kind of an awkward timing, but I just didn't think it would be like completely closed. Basically what happened was we got to the farmer's market and they closed. I couldn't take pictures there. Ava tried to finesse the warehouse. She got some pics, so I don't know where I'm going, but we'll see in a minute. So we just discovered this entire new area of our city. I'm taking pictures right here in front of this wooden thing, and then there's also a bodega on the corner that I'm gonna take pictures in front of, so let's see what we can do. Pictures are all done. Okay, this is photo spot 2 for the photo dump. Just a little bench. How y'all doing?
You guys, look, there's a dog in the window. You guys, there's another dog. What is going on today?
This is a side note, but we stopped at this bodega. I didn't even know our city had bodegas, okay? But this is Olipop, classic root beer. It's really good, but it's also, I think, okay, it has prebiotics and 2 grams of sugar per can. And it's really good. I think there's like a Coke flavor, but I haven't tried that one yet. So how do you feel about our day so far?
I like it. I'm still thrown off from yesterday when he took me to work out.
I was talking about this in my video, how I thought it was going to change my life, and I want to show you guys what I've been doing with it. This is weird, but I put it on my eyebrows because I like my eyebrows to stay up like during the day. Like, and recently I've just been like brushing them up and it keeps them up. Like, I feel like they look better this way when they're all up, but that helps it hold up. And then also, anyway, I thought it would be fun if we did a little PR unboxing, just because I wouldn't be getting PR if it wasn't for you guys. So let's just do a little unboxing. I have about 4 packages here. So L'Oreal Paris sent me some new hair products. That's what it looks like. And it literally hit the helicopter on my ceiling. They're all like bond strengthening, so shampoo, conditioner, and a pre-shampoo. I've never heard of a pre-shampoo before. I think this Pepsi is reacting with the Vaseline, listen. Another package from Caudalie, one of my favorites. I absolutely love Caudalie. Everything that they have is really, really great. But they sent me the Vinyl Perfect serums. Oh, cool. Okay, so it's just these 2 serums, and they're for like brightening like your complexion and your under eye. One's for your under eye, one's just for like your overall complexion. I've used them before, and I actually really like them. Oh my god, they sent a little thing for the serum. It's like a marble, and you kind of just like rub it on your skin. That's nice. I'm just not realizing that most of my PR is skincare, like literally all of it, because the next one is Kiehl's and the next one is La Roche. This is from Kiehl's. This packaging is so cool, isn't it? Okay, I'm not gonna lie, I already opened this and I already used it, and let me give you my thoughts about it because I actually like it. So this is a cleanser, but it's a powder cleanser, which I was scared to use because I've never used it before, but it actually turned out working like really well. And these are both for your pores. I literally used it one time and like my nose pores, I was like, whoa, like that was crazy. I did save one of the best for last, this ginormous La Roche Posay box. If you guys have been following me for a long time now, you would know. These are like my OGs. Like, this is my OG skincare brand. Look at all of this. Like, what are you talking about? Some of these I haven't used before, but I'm just gonna tell you the ones that I actually use because I use them on like a daily basis. Hydrating Gentle Cleanser, 10 out of 10. This is the cleanser I use every single day, 10 out of 10. Like 10 out of 10. Sunscreen, this is also the sunscreen that I use every day, and I'm going to tell you guys, 10 out of 10. And the moisturizer, this is also one of my favorites. So these three,
The cleanser, the moisturizer, and the sunscreen are literally like my everyday routine. Okay, these are not PR, but they're just something that I'm absolutely like obsessed with. I haven't been obsessed with shoes like this in a really long time, but they're the Adidas Campus 2000s, I think Adidas Campus 00s. I did want to make a really quick announcement on here though, that I will be linking anything you guys see in my videos, my shoes, my outfits, my clothes, my accessories, anything that you see in my room, I will be uploading to this app called LTK, which is where basically I post everything that I use and you guys can shop it. So check out the link in my description for any and everything that I use. I wanted to do a quick fit check. I didn't really put too much effort into this, so keep that in mind, but it's just kind of like a casual outfit. My ripped jeans, the shoes, I could not wait to wear them. And then this cream cardigan.
Finally, where was she? Hi.
What?
What?
Why are you smiling at me?
I'm just smiling at you.
Didn't know I was being paparazzi.
Yeah, I was waiting. Like it looks when I'm with you.
How can us lose and miss the moment? You just do it for it. He wouldn't let me take the pictures because I'm not an influencer anymore. Nobody like you do. I can
lose when I'm with you. You guys, the coffee you spilled, first thing I said was get a video for my vlog.